Hey, I thought you guys weren't supposed to get here till 2:30.
It's only...
Alright. Well, I'm hungry anyway, so let's go to the kitchen. Welcome to Lazy Cooking. I'm your host, Liam. What I'm going to do is teach you how to make real easy meals in very little time, with very few ingredients, and you're not going to have to clean up anything. First thing we're going to make is the classic grilled cheese sandwich. Any lazy person can make that, right? Now you're saying to me, oh, but Liam, I already know how to make a grilled cheese. Yeah, but you don't know how to do it without a stovetop or a pan. I'm going to teach you another way. This is an ironing board, and this is an iron. So your first step is to get your iron heated up, so plug it in and put it to the side and don't burn yourself. While that's heating up, you're going to want to grab a piece of tin foil. I recommend the stuff that's pre-cut, it's perfect for sandwich-sized things, and you don't have to tear the tin foil, which is an absolutely painstaking task, as we all know. Then you want to grab bread. I recommend white bread, or whatever bread you prefer, but you know, white bread, that's the standard for a grilled cheese sandwich. Your next step is to butter the bread. So you're going to gingerly butter both sides of both pieces of bread. Now, as you can see, I'm using this plastic knife, because if you used silverware, you'd have to wash it.
There you go.
Thanks, man. Appreciate it. And as my roommate so eloquently put it, there is a much easier way to do this, and that is the spray butter. It is just as delicious, and you don't even have to use a plastic knife.
And I will demonstrate that in this close-up.
If you don't butter your bread on both sides, you could potentially start a fire. And believe me when I say that it can definitely happen.
911, what's your emergency?
I was trying to make a sandwich with an iron and we started a fire.
Sir, did you butter both sides of the bread?
No.
Remember, fire bad. Your next step is to pick your cheese. I recommend picking two of your favorite delicious cheeses and mixing them together. You get more flavors, you get more colors, and you got the same amount of work.
So as you can see here, we have yellow American and mozzarella cheese.
So you slap those bad boys on there, you cover up your sandwich, and you fold it over. Only fold over one side, don't fold it over again, otherwise you'll be favoring one side with tinfoil, and you don't want to do that. So, here we go. You grab your iron, which should be hot by now, and you press it to the sandwich. If you listen closely, you can hear that it is sizzling. Now remember, you can always add extra stuff, extra spices like oregano or garlic powder or onion powder to your sandwich, or you can add ham or anything you like, but we're sticking to the regular grilled cheese here. You want to make sure that you press around the sandwich with the iron to make it even on all sides, and all corners of course. Alright, when the first side is done, you're going to want to flip it over, like so. Careful, it's very hot. And side two! I'm going to say this sandwich is just about done, so let's check it out. We open up the tin foil, and we have a beautiful, delicious, nutritious grilled cheese sandwich. The next step is to take it, put it on a plastic or a paper plate, so you don't have to clean anything. I recommend garnishing your sandwich with some chips, barbecue, or sour cream and onion are absolutely perfect for a grilled cheese sandwich. You put them on the side or inside your grilled cheese sandwich for a bonus crunch and flavor. No mess, easy, no fuss, and absolutely delicious. So you can get back to the couch or wherever else you want to go. Personally, I like the couch. Anyway, this has been Lazy Cooking with me, Liam. Have a good one.